Hey guys, how are you? We're playing more Skyrim today. Oof, that's a scary looking thing. I hate running into those. I don't actually know much about them because that's one of the DLCs that I haven't played, like purposefully yet. I wanted to get my character up to where I wanted it to be, like really high level before even starting that quest. And so I never have played it
Spiced
because
wine, the taste of home and hearth.
I keep starting the game over. Jeez, it looked like I was standing on a thing
I've got a little work
to
if
me.
you're interested, traveler.
Okay, so. Oh goodness, there's so much here. Oh my gosh, there's so much here, guys. Where do we even start? Should we pick up some side quests? What can we do in solitude? Well, I know that we. Wait, did we do that? We did that, didn't we? Yes, we have to. Well, we're gonna return to. We're gonna go to Windhelm. I was gonna go the long way and discover Dawnstar and Winterhold and stuff. I could talk to that guy. Right.
Straight from the fjord, the taste of home and
Let's
heart.
see, I could.
Arms and armor, forged by a master craftsman.
Oh, goodness. I could do a lot of stuff. I'm gonna go this direction. Just to, like, check everything out. Okay, so you can't actually. This is the Bard's College that everyone tells us about. Oh. Seriously, though, like, this is pretty cool. To think that right now I'm standing on a natural stone arch. I can't see, of course, over, but it's still cool. Alright, so I've discovered the Blue Palace. Yeah, I think that's probably good for now. There is so much to do. Oh my gosh, I cannot even tell you. Guys, Skyrim is a huge game. That's the creepy guy. I don't want to start with Daedric quests yet, though. So we'll leave him for a little while. I would really love to do this in an organized fashion, but the best way that I know how to play Skyrim is literally just go around and talk to everybody and collect all of the quests and then do them in whatever order you think you want to. So, yeah, I know. Let me know how that works out for you. I'm really considering this guy because it doesn't follow another one, but it's close to one of the eventual sorry, the words just left my mouth. Thieves Guild. One of the actual Thieves Guild quests. Yeah, okay, I'll talk
You're
to him.
passing through solitude? Maybe you're looking to make some easy gold, yes?
That's always my goal in life. What did you have in mind?
It's easy to find things to sell. Things nobody will miss. Things from underground, or just left lying around in someone's house. I bet the two of us were very alike. So why not take
You're
the next
so
step?
creepy.
We can help each other. My sister Deja and I are treasure hunters. We like to collect things.
Well, I'm definitely not no thief, so I'm listening.
I knew you looked like a clever one. With the war, many more ships come through these docks, loaded with weapons and pay, but few people, and they pass through dangerous waters.
That's right.
We have an interest in one of those boats, the Ice Runner. The Solitude Lighthouse will be guiding it in, but if its fire were to go out, the Ice Runner would run aground.
By the way, I'm sorry if you guys can hear the skipping in the sound that I'm hearing. Just throwing that out there. So you want me to put out the lighthouse fire?
What an interesting idea. I think if someone were to do something like that, there would definitely be a certain amount of loot to be shared.
Hypothetically.
Yes, if someone were to put out the lighthouse fire and then meet me on the docks afterwards, I could certainly direct them to that loot.
What would happen to the sailors on the boat?
Don't worry about them. We'll make sure they wash up safe. Maybe they'll even pay us for the heroic rescue from their sad crash.
This guy is trying way too hard. Setting up a wreck? I should turn you into the guards.
Turn me in? For what? What crime's been committed? I'm just making idle talk about what would most undoubtedly be a tragic event. A tragic and very, very profitable event.
Okay.
It would be best if we spoke little until you've completed your task.
Alright. Yeah. It probably would be best. What is that? They have vents in Skyrim. That's nuts. Okay, so now I have this new quest to put out the fire in the Solitude Lighthouse. Well, that's practically on the way where I'm going, so I might as well just do it. Right? Yeah. Hello, everyone. Oh my gosh, guys, I love this game so much. I don't know if I have ever... I mean, I'm sure you guys have figured out right by now how much I love this game. It's a lot. I love this game. So, this is the carriage I was talking about. We could just talk to this guy and be like, hey, can you take us to Windhelm?
Good day.
But we'll walk. We got feet. Right? Oh, Catless Farm. And this little bridge here. I love this bridge. It's amazing. I mean, it's, you know, cool. I'll show you guys what I like to do. This is one of the few places where, like, digital feels like real life. Whoops. I missed. So you get up here and you're like, oh! Woo! Oh, I always get... Whoa! That's never happened before. I've always made it. Dang it! I didn't realize that that could happen. Well, now I know how to commit suicide in Skyrim. That is actually kind of disappointing. I don't know what mod slash patch made it that way. But before, you could always jump from that bridge and you would just splash in the water merrily and not die. But no more. They kill you if you do that. But it was fun. It was like jumping off a high dive. Did you guys feel it too? Because I totally felt like the feeling in the pit of my stomach. So I wonder how they work with what is it? Bard's Leap or Bruca's Leap or something? It's like a dungeon somewhere that's got Forsworn in it that has this big like gargoyle that has water flowing from its mouth, and you can run out to the edge and jump off of it, and like your character actually does like a little swan dive and you land gracefully in the thing. Yeah. Oh, did I just pass it? I just did. You can get up into Solitude that way too. Oh my gosh, look at all the flowers. God, I love flowers. Because they can make you money. But not the way orphans use them. You have to make them into potions. So we actually, I don't know if I've discussed this too much, but we moved out to the country a few months ago. And I love it out here. It's amazing. But I, like... have this. Let's see, where's the lighthouse? Alright, we'll go ahead and mark the quest. Yeah. Okay, so. But I still, like, I want to go around and find out what, like, all the flowers and plants are, and if there's any way I can use them, like, in cooking, or. I don't know, to try to make essential oils or something. Like, I feel like it would be really cool to go out with a basket and, like, pick a whole bunch of herbs and then be able to actually do stuff with them. Does that make sense? Here's the... Here it is. Found the path, guys. Oh, nope, it's up there. I lied. I didn't find the path. I missed the path. Anyway, so yeah, I would love to actually get into quote-unquote potion making using ingredients from our 8.5 acres that we can grow here in the Midwest, which I don't know if there's anything valuable that you can grow here in the Midwest. Oh, I don't think I knew that path went on. I'm going to have to... This is probably going to be an exploring episode, and I hope that's okay with you guys. Yeah. Alright, so we got the lighthouse. And you can go in and visit the lighthouse keeper. But we're not gonna bother. We're just gonna put out the lighthouse far. And then we're not gonna go bother talking to Jawri Ra for a while. Oh! Lydia, you scared me. I thought you were like a person. I mean, you are a person, but you know what I meant. Okay. I really hope that didn't make you, like, super terribly ill. I'm gonna go check where this path goes. I have to go the other direction, though. We have to go east to Windhelm, not west. Oh, and the toddler's awake. Let's see. Well, this has only been 15 minutes. Maybe he'll go back to sleep. I actually would like it if you would go back to sleep, so we'll... Okay, we're gonna start sneaking. Brine Water Grotto. I know where this is. I never realized. Very cool. Hey, look, there's an orcish bow. Ah, sure, we'll take it. What the heck. Now, we're gonna head up. It would be awesome if you could, like, take boats, but we're just gonna be swimming. There's a little fox that's swimming, too. Yep. Oh, goodness. Okay, so now we're going to be swimming for a while. We'll probably swim over here and then walk along the coast. Yeah, that's what we'll do. I want to get a few of the locations in here marked so that we can fast travel to, like, this wilderness pretty quickly. But, yes, and in Skyrim, cold water is excellent for your leather apparel. Just so you guys know. Whee! And yes, you can jump in water. I don't know how that works. But you can do it. I tried to zoom out. That's kind of what it looks like. If you guys have ever wanted to jump in water where you couldn't touch, that's how you do it. It really doesn't feel like we're moving very fast at all. Because if I try to zoom out to give us more perspective, it just shoves me underwater. Oh, I see the Nairn root, I think. I guess that could just be the snow. Yeah, it looks like it's just the snow. I thought this little mist was a Nairn root. How disappointing. Okay, now I can walk on the ice. That's a creepy looking rock. Yeah, I'm not even gonna try it. I'm gonna miss that guy. I just wanna get this one marked. I don't know what it is. Highgate Ruins. Kroger, and they got gold. Oh, that's nice. Alright. Hey, there's a ship. We'll get the ship marked. Is that a... That might be a... I'm sorry, guys. I don't have any words right now, and so they're all just, like, leaving me, like, hanging. Stone. I think so. A sign? A stone? Oh, I don't remember what it's called. I am so sorry that I don't have words. Nope. It's just a place where some horkers are hanging out. Now, once Lydia catches up, she should enjoy beating you up. So I can literally sneak backwards at the same rate. Whoops. That you were. Alright, fine. You're gonna make me get my...
Take this and hold on to it. I'll be back for it later.
Okay.
Good. No time to talk.
Yes.
Snitch or double cross me and I'll kill you. I need it.
I don't know what he gave me, but we'll check it out. Ah, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die from a stinking horker. Oh yeah, he took all the skooma from that guy. Guess we could do that. How many? We only have one of each. I am so bad at this right now. I knew Lydia would like beating you up, you horker. That was horrible. Guys, I am so sorry you had to watch me almost get killed by a horker. Now, let's see what that guy... There should be someone else coming up behind him. Probably that guy. I kind of want to just shoot them both. But I think this is the guy that...
Did you see someone run past just now?
So we got an orcish bow of frost from that guy. I don't remember what happens if you get... Well, this guy's a hunter. Let's say, yeah, he went that way.
Great. Thanks. Bastard stole from me. I'll catch him though. Found you. Let's see what you got.
We'll catch you. Let's see what else you got on you. I don't think it's much. That's right. I took him out. But we're gonna loot him. Yeah, he doesn't have much. Ah, there's a spider somewhere. Alright, so... Oh my goodness, there's like a million of them. At least they're easy. They're actually like frosty frostbite spiders. Alright. So after this, did the other two fall through the world? Looks like the other two might have just fallen through the world. Unless they went back here. Nope, they fell through the world. Alright. Well, I think I'm gonna have to call it an episode. It's been about 20 minutes, which is about my episode-ish time. I had to start timing myself. I was really good with the first couple episodes, and then I just got carried away. And I was doing, like, 40-minute episodes, which, you know, I mean, don't really mind 40-minute episodes, but it's just a little excessive, I think. So, We'll get up to the ship and see what the ship is. I don't remember. I think it's... I've got a whole bunch of just stuff going on in my brain, and I don't even know. What is this quest? What is this ship? What's it called? Wreck of the Brine Hammer. Aha! I did remember that. Okay, so, whoops, something... There's a mud crab up there. Okay, good. I'm at least getting good enough to where I can one-shot mud crabs. Oh my gosh. Okay, so we're gonna call the episode quits here, and I will see you guys next time. Yeah. Have a good Monday tomorrow! I don't know what day I'm gonna upload this, so tomorrow might not be Monday for you, but today is Sunday for me. So, yeah. See ya!